What's up, guys? This is Random Reviews, and today we're going to do episode 99 of Random Reviews. And today we're going to do... Today we're going to do a movie suggested by... Thank you for the suggestion, James Moss. Today we're going to do the 1988 classic horror movie, Waxwork. And boy, was it good. I really actually enjoyed it. So yeah, Waxwork came in 88. It stars, of course, Zach Galligan from the Gremlins movies, and David Warner, and some other people. Yeah, wow, $3 million, wow. Alright, whatever. $3 million, wow. I mean, it really shows. Yeah, Waxwork is about, let me see. Yeah. Yes, which is about college students that trapped in the wax museum and meet Count Dracula and other stuff. I mean, that is true too, but... Okay, let me see. Let me turn on the light here. That is too bright. Whoops, that is way too bright. There we go. There we go, just perfect. Just perfect for my amusement. So you guys can hear it in the background. I'm watching Legend of Korra, probably not. So yeah, Waxwork, I really actually enjoyed. It's just a weird-ass movie. Yeah, here we go. So yeah. Yeah. It's like when I heard of it, it's like I heard of it from somewhere, and then I forgot if it even existed, and then it's just like, I mean, the makeup effects are pretty good though. The makeup and stuff. Yeah, spoiler if you haven't seen the movie yet. Here's one of my favorite scenes in the movie, which is the vampire or the werewolf scene. Yes. See, that makeup looks good. That's one of my favorite parts of the movie. There are so many other good parts of this movie. It's just like, tries to be so many movies at once. It's like, I understand what they were going for, but it's just like, stick to the main plot about the haunted wax museum. It's like, I'm not saying this movie's bad. I'm saying it's really good, but it's just so weird and wacky. It's like, I don't even know where to put it. Because it's like, and then you got this scene too, where she's being force-fed meat of some sort from Count Dracula herself. Which is kind of weird, and to be honest, it's like, it's not a bad film. It's a good film, but it's just honestly really, really weird. It's like, I understand what you're trying to go. Like, I totally understand. But, yeah. There are just some parts where it's like, meh. Yeah, like another scene. You can kind of hear the movie. All copyright goes to the Life of Owners, but I'm just using it for educational purposes. Like, the makeup's really well done for only, like, under $4 million. It really shows up what you could do. Hold on, I'm trying to find it. I don't want my channel to get too graphic. Because I'm not dead meat here. Or here's a pretty cool scene where she kills the vampire Dracula, I believe, or just one of them. That is pretty cool effects. But yeah, I don't want to show you the rest because it's like, I don't want my channel to be over 18. It's like my channel is for 13 plus, but it's just like, yeah. I don't want to be too graphic, if you know what I mean. It's like, it's not a bad movie. Yeah, there are just so many scenes, you just have to watch it. It's on Tubi. I'll leave a link in the description below. I'll try to. But, yeah. It's just... I don't know. I'll give it an 8. Just for creativity. Trying to be too many things at once. It's, like, hard to tell. Yeah, because it's a vampire movie, a mummy movie, a werewolf movie. A Napoleon movie in one. And then later on in the movie... Yeah, I don't know how much footage I could show, but I don't want to show too much footage. Because then I'm spoiling the rest of the movie if you have not seen it. Of course, there's always an ad, great. Yeah, oh, that's great. But anyway, I'm just going to describe it because it's kind of hard to explain, but I'm going to try to describe it. Like, towards the last, like, 15 minutes of the movie is the best part. Where the main kid's grandpa, I think he's his grandpa or his dad of some sort. I think. Probably one of his uncles, I believe, but yeah. That they get together and they fight all the evil wax museum all the wax figures and stuff at the end of the movie. The whole fight scene towards the end is the best part of the movie, in my opinion. Yeah. Waxwork, which is an interesting movie. It's pretty good for a 1980s horror movie. For a late 80s horror movie, it's pretty good. Yeah, it's not bad. Don't worry, I'm gonna watch the sequel probably tomorrow. Because I have so many things to catch up on. Because right now, yeah. So right now for requests, the next episode is gonna be huge. It's gonna be a huge video compilation. Well, not really, but it's just like for episode 100, I'm gonna do all the Star Wars movies, all 13 of them. Or at least the theatrical ones. I'm not gonna cover like the shows. I'll cover those eventually in my own time. Yeah. And then, and after we do the Star Wars special, yeah, I'm just going to call it the episode 100 Star Wars special, where I review each individual movie, and that's going to be at least 30 minutes long. Who knows, maybe it'll be in the parts, who knows. I could try to squeeze all 13 movies in 35 minutes or less, but yeah. What else is there? Yeah, and then after that, I'm going to do 7, be on the lookout for that later tonight, which was suggested by CEO Bam, and then after that... In and after that, of course, we're going to do Phantom of the Opera, the original. Because that was also suggested by CEO Bam. Don't worry, I'm going to do all your requests later. And probably later, when I get a chance, I'm going to review the first Prom Night movie. Because that was also suggested by James Moss. Shout out to you, my friend. Yeah. And then, what else is there? I think that's it for all the submissions. Well, 2 movies I'm not going to do right now at the moment, of course, is Shocker. Because I can't find it, because it's on HBO Max, and I don't have that. So I'll wait until it's free somewhere. I'll just wait until it's on TV or something. Yeah. And then American Werewolf in London, which was submitted by an anonymous person on YouTube. Who I guess got his channel deleted. Or deleted his channel, I'm not sure. And I'll get to that later because it's also on stupid HBO Max, I believe. So yeah, that's going to be the schedule for the next couple days. So yeah, you got... Yeah, like I said before, you got a big franchise, and then you got... what am I reviewing again? Oh yeah, 7. You got a crime movie with Brad Pitt and Morgan Freeman, and then you got Phantom of the Opera, the original 1925 classic. Which I have not seen yet. I've seen like the first 15 minutes of it. It's interesting, but yeah. I mean, it's a silent film. What do I do? Yeah. So anyway, be on the lookout for the Star Wars video coming soon. Peace!